as a mom, I really hope that all PID patients are given priorities to get access to immunoglobulin therapy.
When people can't access their immunoglobulin on a regular basis or not at all, their life is just in danger.
It's extremely important to have the continuous flow of your immunoglobulin supply to protect your patient population.
Immunoglobulin replacement therapies, or IG therapies, are essential medicines for children and adults living with a primary immunodeficiency. They are recognized as essential medicines by the World Health Organization and other international organizations and countries. Yes, access to IG therapies remains a challenge for many of PID patients.
As for the immunoglobulins, these are life-saving medicines that are obtained from a complex supply chain. And this supply chain starts from the collection of human plasma, which is a scarce resource.
For countries that do not collect plasma, it is very, very important because we depend on other countries to collect plasma to be able to access to that gamma globulin that is produced elsewhere. The shortages as a fact, and even the threat of having shortages of gamma globulin, is very devastating for patients and families and parents with children living with primary immunodeficiencies, because there's a constant stress of not being able to provide to their children or to themselves of something that is really vital for them.
During the time of a shortage, I was very worried. Sometimes I got stressed out and I don't even want to let him go to school because I feel like he was most fragile at that moment. Like he can get any infection anytime. I feel like wrapping him up and make him stay at home all the time, but that was not possible. Apart from that, I was quite stressed out because I need to watch him like 24/7 to make sure that there's no serious infection going on, and also to make sure that he's in very good condition, good health.
Thanks to my immunoglobulin therapy, I am able to go to school, see my friends, and finally play sports with them.
Whilst efforts to collect more plasma to meet the growing demand for IG therapies are crucial, it is of paramount importance to guarantee that the collected plasma and the resulting IG therapies meet all the necessary safety, quality, and efficacy standards. A robust regulatory oversight is therefore needed to ensure patients can access safe and efficacious therapies. Ensuring a safe and sufficient supply of plasma requires first an important collection effort. Then regulatory agencies come into play. These agencies play a pivotal role in overseeing and ensuring the safety, quality, and efficacy of plasma collection and the resulting immunoglobulin therapies.
The role of regulatory agency is crucial because in the last years and more, we can see immunoglobulin accessing the market in some countries where the patient have no real safe, efficacious immunoglobulins because they have not been scrutinized by the agencies. And this put their life at risk because of the lack of quality, efficacy, and sometimes safety. In addition to that, we can see also that counterfeit immunoglobulin enter some countries, especially those who are very low regulated. And this is a big issue for those patients.
Pharmacovigilance activities and marketing authorization are fundamental roles that are played by the regulatory agencies to protect the public's health.
Once the product is authorized, the regulatory agencies continue playing a role, and this is called the pharmacovigilance. This means that once the product is in the market, the product will be followed. In this way, we can assure that the product will be kept up to date with all the technological progress and that we will have the safest and more efficacious possible product in the market. And with all of these mechanisms, we have achieved a lot. And For example, there have not been cases of viral transmission such as hepatitis or HIV since the early 90s.
IPOPI is working very hard so that every patient in the world can access a safe, efficacious and quality immunoglobulin. And this is the reason why we support our national member organization to have this access in their own country. We need that every immunoglobulin is checked by a regulatory body, and we have to combat the initiative that would provide patients with counterfeit and also bad quality immunoglobulins.
In particular in the field of immunoglobulins, I think it is very important that we find the right balance between access for patients, not only in the high-income countries, but around the globe, affordability, but also reward for innovation. Immunoglobulin treatment is costly due to the involved production process and strict quality control procedures.
Coverage of immunoglobulin therapies over the world is quite a big issue because in some countries, patients are totally covered for their life-saving treatments. But the reality is that in many countries, this is not the case at all.
I am aware of patients experiencing financial problems to cover immunoglobulin, especially those patients with secondary immunodeficiencies that at least in Chile, the system doesn't cover the immunoglobulin for them. And other countries in Latin America do not guarantee access to immunoglobulin for all immunodeficiency patients. Therefore, they have to pay for it out of pocket, and this is a monthly burden.
We need to remember that immunoglobulins are life-saving medicines. Without immunoglobulins, you are susceptible to get infections that can threaten your life. So when people can't access their immunoglobulin on a regular basis or not at all, their life is just in danger.
In the Netherlands, immunoglobulin therapy, IgG therapy, is reimbursed for both children with a PID, elderly with a PID, and also the so-called secondary immunodeficiencies.
For the IVIG, immunoglobulin through therapin, it is all covered by government in Malaysia. If you are being prescribed by the doctors, you can just walk in and get it at any time with no, you don't have to pay anything. But for his, for my son's situation right now, since he's going through different method using the subcute, we have to apply through the government department. Luckily for government servant like me, I can go through that channel and apply for that. I really hope in Malaysia, subcute will be common treatment and everybody will be able to get access to it as soon as possible.
The World Health Organization is working hard on the concept of universal coverage. What does it mean? It means that every single patient can access their treatment, safe, efficacious and quality treatment without any financial hardship. This is a fact that in the world, many patients die just because they can't access their life-saving treatments. This is the reason why at IPOPI, we want to have every patient accessing their life-saving treatment, no matter where they live.
Every patient in need deserves safe, effective, and high-quality immunoglobulin therapies that are rigorously approved and continuously monitored. All countries should take measures to increase their plasma collection to ensure patients have access to their life-saving treatment everywhere without financial burden.